Hello everyone and welcome to Off The Shelf Reviews Gaming Fridays. I'm Gary.
And I'm Geoff.
And today we're going to look at FTL.
Yeah.
Faster Than Light, which came out in 2012.
Yep.
And I got to say, as soon as the game came out, I looked at it, I was excited by it. I hadn't signed up to Steam, but I thought, I'm going to do it anyway. Signed up to Steam, and this was the only game I downloaded and paid for. And don't ever regret it. Don't regret it. I've sunk more than 100 hours into this game, and it is so replayable.
Oh, very much so, yeah. It's a roguelike, isn't it? So every time you play it, it's something a little bit different, and it's sort of randomly generated.
I'm glad you said that, because people have been chucking around roguelike quite a bit, and I don't really knew what they were talking about. I just kind of nodded and went, roguelike.
Roguelike means like you'll start the game and pretty much everything in a roguelike is procedurally generated, so it's different every time, and it's a kind of survival thing, you know? So this is an FTL, a faster than light roguelike, and you could say really it's a kind of ship management survival game. It's one I'm quite a big fan of, actually. Just like you said, you really, you know, wanted it, played it, and then once you got into it, it was really addictive. Well, I got really addicted.
I can see that. Damn! You've unlocked every single ship in the game.
Almost, yeah, I think so. I've got all the Type A's, all the Type B's, and all the Type C's. Yeah, there we go.
Wow.
I don't think there is a Type C. I haven't done all the achievements yet, but I have completed it on normal. And let's have a look. I did have, if I go back one, I can show you my stats. I've done all right.
Okay, you've played it 109 times. I think I'm down to like 50 or 60. My total victories is probably on like 10.
Yeah. I mean, I've seen some of the players on YouTube with like numbers in the hundreds and single figure victories.
But that's the thing. This game is notoriously difficult. But it's the fact that you don't know whether this run that you're making is going to be the one that gets you to the end, and you might just die spectacularly at the end boss. Or you just might not even make it halfway.
Yeah.
And for this video, it's kind of going to be a special video. We're going to play this game that you do, Geoff, in its entirety.
Yeah.
So the video could be 20 minutes long, or it could be 2 hours long.
Yep. It's just going to be till I die.
Until you die or complete the game, Geoff.
Yeah, okay. Well,
so it's pretty important right now that we choose the right ship.
I've got three different layouts of... So I'm just going to use the basic ship, which is called the Kestrel.
Right, we've got to do something about that. let's call it something else.
Let's call it...
Yeah,
okay,
rename.
Here we go. Let's call it... OTS Enterprise, shall we? There we go.
Off the shelf Enterprise. Okay. Okay.
Okay, so we can change the layout. So I'm going to choose layout 2 because we've got...
Change the name again.
So it did. Well, I'm going to go for layout B.
It has basic laser and basic laser. And basically two more basic lasers after that.
Yeah.
Four basic lasers. And it looks like you already have 4 power in the weapons. So they're all good to go from the get-go.
That's right, yeah. So we've got like our main systems here. And then you have your characters which sit in the...
The various zones. So we've got weapons control. We've got engine room. And we've got shields. And a med bay. And we've also got an oxygen room. Door control room and a bridge.
Yes, we have got your characters you can move these around. It's best if I just go in and start showing you now. So we'll go in. You start out. The data you carry is vital to the remaining Federation fleet. You'll need supplies for the journey, so make sure to explore each sector before moving on to the next. But get to the exit before the pursuing rebel fleet can catch up. And then you get a little tip about the different systems. It's talking about ion systems. Right, so I've got these guns here, and I can switch them on by clicking on them, or I can hotkey them 1 to 4. And I've got my men here, and I can move them into different rooms, see, just by right-clicking on the room. and they will add a little bonus to the room that they are in. So, and then you've got different characters that have different properties. So
we got a dude called Wei Xing, and he, I believe, is an alien that actually generates energy.
That's right.
So whatever room he's in, it's like having an additional power. So we can see that he's in weapons control, and he's got a little yellow nodule, which indicates his bonus energy.
At the top here, you've got your hull strength. There's your current scrap total. That's how many drone parts you've got, that's how many missiles you've got, and that's how much fuel you've got. If that goes down to zero, you are dead in space. And we have weapons, engines, shields, medbay, cameras, O2, doors, and the pilot. And if I click on ship, this is how you upgrade them. As you can see, you've got scrap value to upgrade each of these systems. Upgrading your shields will give you more little blue dots on your shields to help protect you. You'll need two more dots on there to get one more blue dot on your shield, as you can see.
So that would be 40 scrap total, I'm guessing. Or 50 even, looking at the upgrade meter on the right.
This will go up exponentially. So as you can see, you got the first one will cost you 20, then it costs you 30 scrap for the next upgrade. And it keeps going up, so you would have to spend 100 scrap to get to 3 shield barriers and 180 to get to 4 shield barriers.
Okay, so we need a lot of scrap, and we need fuel.
You've also got to have the power to put it in as well.
Yep, lots to do, lots to upgrade.
Lots and lots. So I'm going to, first of all, I'm going to straight away move this guy into here, into my engine room, and I'm going to move him down to there. Because then I can take that power away, and it gives me means I've always got one in my engine. If I've got more power in my engine, I can dodge shots a bit better. But this is the map. Now I've got, this is the first sector, sector one, the civilian sector, and I can jump from point to point to point in whatever fashion I want. As you can see, each point indicates where you can jump to next. And I can jump to that exit point anytime I want. But if I leave it as late as possible, I'll have as much opportunity to get as much scrap over here as I can.
It's one of the most addictive things about this game is that you cannot ever reach every single destination on that map, because obviously when you hover your cursor over each of those destinations, you can see the trajectory that you're going to be traveling in, and you basically have to map an equal amount of number of jumps to when you're going to hit the exit as to when the rebels are going to catch up with you.
That's right. Now, if I start jumping, you'll begin to see the. I'll have my first encounter,
so,
possibly.
Use the fuel.
Let's see what happens. Yeah, use the fuel. Right. So, first of all, I've jumped straight into this new sector. And there's an enemy here. We've got a hostile pirate.
Blast him. Fire everything.
Well, what you do now is, here he comes. Your crew members keep them barely operational. So, they've hacked my system.
Right.
So, that means my extra power is now not available. It doesn't matter too much right now, but what I have here is I have the enemy ship on the right hand side, and I can use my weapons now to try and take out systems and their shields. Now if I he's got a laser and a missile, and the missiles will just scoot straight past my shields. I really don't want that. So I'm paused, that's fine. You can pause this game and plan out your strategy and set things in motion.
I have to say that pausing is an absolute necessity in order to beat this game, yes.
Definitely, yeah. You will have to pause it. You'll have to think about how to manage your ship. But I've just set all my lasers to fire on their weapon systems. They will have to break through the shields because they're lasers. But they won't fire until they're fully charged up. And their weapon systems are also charging up. So, can I get my first volley away before he shoots me?
Okay, so he went past his shields, took out his weapons, but he hit you with a missile, and we got no oxygen on the off-the-shelf Enterprise, Geoff.
So that is a big problem. I've paused it again. As you see, my system's got
through. Get Scoops out of the med bay and get him into oxygen control right now. We don't need him in med bay. He should have been in shields.
Yeah, Scoops should be in shields. You're absolutely correct. And he should also come in weapons because he's terrible at repairing things. So I'm going to have the human repair the ship. As you see, I've clicked their settings. And what happened with the other ship is I've hit his systems. They've gone orange. And that took down his missile. But he's going to be doing exactly the same thing I'm doing. He's going to have people in here rushing to fix this. When my scanners are improved, I will also be able to... I will also be able
to... We need auto-fire. Auto-fire.
See what they're doing. Yeah, so there we go. So I'm going to put all four on there, and I'm going to put auto-fire on.
Yeah.
It. Yeah, there we go. So that means...
Now fire everything! Boom! Now his weapons are down.
Oh, now he's not going to shoot me back. What I could do is I could go...
Oxygen level's down 80% and rising.
That's fine. Bjorn has fixed it. He can go back into the shields, and... His shields are now down, so anything
this,
I hit
this
him
volley
with...
should take him down.
Oh, he's gone.
Score one for the Enterprise.
Yeah, so I got 5 fuel out of that, which is very good.
Nice.
And 22 scrap. Lovely.
Ideal. I didn't see it at the beginning, Geoff, but what difficulty did we choose for this playthrough?
I thought I chose normal, but that was quite a lot of scrap, so this might
I have to say, you are very brave if you've chosen normal. I've still yet to play this game on normal and complete it.
It's very tough, yeah, very tough. I mean, there's a hard saying as well, which is redinky-donk.
I don't even want to imagine. I'm not that masochistic.
So we defeated that. There's no rush for us to jump onto the next sector, but there's nothing else for us to do here. And we haven't got any rebel fleet, so I'm just going to jump to the next available one.
Sounds good to me.
And... Okay, so now we have a moral decision to make. Now, that's the only thing about this, is that your moral decisions really don't have too much of an effect. So you can be as mean as you like.
Well, we have to determine, really, whether we're going to get more from attacking the civilians, which means, well, they're not going to put up much of a resistance, are they?
Nope.
Or we could attack the rebels, possibly blow ourselves up in the process of helping a bunch of civilians that are not really going to help us.
We could do, but then we could blow up the ship, get scrap from the ship, and then the civilians could be like, oh, thank you, and give us something. So I'm gonna be a good guy this time.
We should have taken it from the civilians. You know, we know that there's a giant rebel fleet on the way here. These guys are just going to be... ruined when they get here.
Yeah, well, the rebels
nuclear
are my
apocalypse.
Enemy. I'm going to destroy them all. Okay, so this guy's got a drone.
I can't argue
see,
that.
See him flying around?
He's taking shields. Shields are down.
He's zapping me with his drone, which is bad news. But he's also got a missile launcher, and I don't want him to shoot me with that either.
That's bad news.
So I'm going to firstly go for his missile system so he doesn't bypass my shields with his launcher. I think my shield should hold against the drone solo.
Okay. Well, so long as the drone keeps missing, we should be okay. Looks like missiles come in, and medbay's out.
Ouch. Okay, that's not the end of the world. I'm going to let it fire again on the missile. Oh, the missiles are down, but I'll just...
Nice. Okay, shots are in. Weapons are down.
Right, there we go. Now I'm going to go for his drone thing. Take that out. As you can see, his doors are open because he's getting people in to fix his shit.
Yep, they've just gone into the drone room, we've taken the drone out.
The drone stopped, and now
it's okay. If another volley could finish the ship. Oh, we missed one shot.
But we will kill him on this one. He might get another. Yeah, he's got another one of
missile
these.
Missile coming in. Miss. Oh, damn.
That's okay. Right, so. There we go, I've got 2 fuel, a missile, and 10, and now I can still
supplies.
Steal the civilian supplies. Oh, wow, I'm just going to take it.
Got that drone.
There we go. Now, see, I did a terrible thing there, and that was horrifically immoral, but there's
I can't
no
believe
consequences,
you did that.
Really. There's just no consequences, which is fine, but there
you
is...
You say that. Karma has a way in this game.
Well, it doesn't in this... Well, I mean, yeah, your karma is this game will punish you whether you're nice or bad. But there is a mod for this game called the Captain's Mod. Now, he needs healing because he took a direct blast. Called the Captain's Mod, which makes things a lot more complicated. There's a lot more scenarios you can face. And your moral, ethical choices will have a real impact. So if I was to do that on the Captain's Mod, my crew might go, oh, you're disgusting, I'm going to leave. So I'm going to go to the next sector now.
I'm going to have to say, I did actually install the mod, but when the FTL game updated with Steam, it uninstalled and overwrote
it,
the mod.
You have to stop Steam from updating the game to keep the Captain's Mod on the go.
But it is actually worth checking out if you are a fan of FTL and maybe already played it but didn't go back to it for any reason. It's a good reason to go back. Give it another run through.
Okay, so these guys have offered to upgrade my oxygen system in exchange for some scrap.
Well, it usually costs about 20 for the first one, so budget saving of 4. You're going to do it eventually, maybe?
Yeah, yes, I think I'm going to take that upgrade because that's reasonable. There we go. So that means if I put 2 power in the oxygen now, it will fill up the ship with oxygen much quicker. And it also gives me a little damage buffer. If I get hit in my oxygen thing, that's going to take out one of those squares. And that means I'm not going to be suffocating on the ship.
Straight away. Yep.
Straight away. So
oxygen reserves. Oh, we've got a distress call. Let's go. Might be more civilians we can steal from.
Now you see this big red arc here at the back? That is the rebels coming in. So you've got where the rebels are, and the warning thing tells you where they're going to be at the end of the next jump. So if I was to jump back to that sector there, that would be it. I'd have to fight rebels.
And that's bad news right now. We're ill-equipped to have to fight them.
They will smash us. But now the question is here, do I go down to this distress signal where something's going to happen, but I've only got 3 options to go from, or do I go to here first and see what that reveals? Now you see, your instincts would go, oh, I'm just going to go for this distress signal, but I like to scout out the sector first. I might have enough time to come down and get that distress signal. We'll see. Might be able to stay ahead of the rebels, but I'm going to see. Because you get things like shops, and those are really important because you need the upgrades to get through this game. Now,
we could explore the asteroid field, but our shields aren't really that great. Neither is our pilot just yet, but we should do it anyway.
Yeah, I mean, this is going to be a random thing. I don't think my stats are going to affect this, so it could be damage.
They usually do.
It could be goodies.
Nope.
It's goodies. Oh, we got a mining drone and
some scrap.
More scrap.
Pay for the last oxygen.
That was
near
fine
enough
for a freebie. There we go.
Okay.
Right, so now we've got a store there.
And another distress
call.
And
I've probably got, if I guess, I got 1, maybe 2. 2 I'd be there, and then
I reckon you've got another 3 searches here.
Another 3
and then
jumps.
The exit.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
And then I could get out of here, or maybe go there to the
then
exit.
Yeah,
so
okay.
So I'm going to pick up that distress first, because I want as much scrap to go into the store as I possibly can.
Yep.
Right, we found some refugees drifting in space. It could, it looks as if
could
it
be a trap.
Fleeing rebel advance, could be. I'm going to hail them. Oh, slug interceptors. Ooh, they're coming
for
me. I was
hunting the refugees. Okay.
Yeah. So
let's defend the refugees.
I am going to take... Oh, he's got an ion cannon, so he's going to hurt my shields.
Yeah, he'll bring them down almost straight away.
Yeah.
He fires up weapons first. It's us. Oh, we fired at the same time. Okay, he had our shields, but his weapons are partially down.
Yeah,
targeting shields next.
Down. I think his weapons are down totally, so I'm going to take out his shields now.
So what do you think of the graphics of this game, Geoff? Do you think they just serve a purpose?
Yeah, they do. I mean, it's an indie game. You know, like, you can't expect too much from them. And they've clearly gone for the playability. I got to be honest. It's not going to matter too much because it's a static image. It would have been nice if they'd maybe made the assets 1080p, so I could have had it, you know, like a bit bigger screen without all the stretching. But you know, it's not really important for this game.
It has a very retro vibe to it. It does remind me of the Mega Drive era of gaming.
A little bit. Yeah, certainly big chunky graphics.
Yeah, I really like the simplistic design of it all. I really like the interface of everything.
Mm-hmm.
I think the graphics do serve a purpose very well. There's plenty of different variety in the different alien characters and the different ship designs, and I absolutely love all of the space backgrounds.
Yeah, there's all sorts of different things. They get actually in their Captain's Mod. Actually, they add more backgrounds and more interesting things in the background. But I mean, there's so much text in this game, and there's so much like potential possibilities.
If it was like Geometry Wars special effects going off in the background, you just wouldn't be able to focus on the micromanaging that you have to do.
Yeah, you don't want too many distractions.
Yeah.
Right, I picked up another quest there. Somebody was like, oh, come
and help
me.
He needs to be dropped off.
So he's up there, which
but
I
would suggest they can be quite important to do. So you could hit, but you'd have to go to the exit and then use the fuel to go to the quest, then back again.
Yeah, and it will depend if I've got enough time with the rebels. But I'm going to go to the store first.
First store? Shop.
Yeah,
okay.
Now let's see what we've got.
74 scrap.
Valuable technology for sale. Okay, so now I can buy. I got two pages.
I do suggest we fix the holes in the ship first.
Now this is the question. Do you? Reconstructive teleport.
The teleporters are quite interesting for combat, especially if we build an away team to go on board the enemy ships.
Yeah, that is very...
Then we can take enemy ships as better salvage.
It's very powerful, that one is. We've also got cloaking, which I can't afford.
We do also have a mantis alien on board.
Yeah, we do. Reconstructive teleport is very powerful, but without
not so good.
It's not going to be useful for us right now.
No.
Drone control is a little out of our reach until we sell something.
We've got plenty of lasers, but we do use them all.
I've got a solo flat cannon, which isn't very exciting. Firebombs, which work incredibly well with rock people if you get them. That is the thing. You can add people to your crew, but there's no crew like.
What's the Zoltan shield bypass?
Okay, so the Zoltan is that little guy here that gives the extra power. And when you meet their shields, they've always got this... bar at the top, that like that is full up, that bar.
Yeah.
And you've got to shoot that down before you can even start getting to their shields.
Nice, okay. So it's only useful against those aliens.
Yeah, and it blocks out missiles and bombs as well, which normal shields don't. So that allows you to just go straight past that and start bombing them.
I'm going to say that this store doesn't really have anything useful, and I would use the money for ship upgrades.
I'm going to keep my ship as it is for the moment and save my money. One of the things I found that was really a smart idea for this game was save your money to begin with. Find that store that's got that killer thing and
go for that.
Go for that, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so yeah, see, I just got a heavy laser now.
You just found that as well.
Yeah,
well, they
just
gave
it
to you.
Yeah.
I would say we equip it and take off one of the lasers.
Now, it's going to require a single power, but you remember your charge times as well. These will make a difference, especially if you're using auto fire. If you've got different fire times, like the way that your volleys hit the ships, especially if they've got shields on, will quite heavily affect how much damage you can do.
Do it. Do it.
But this one will do more damage when it's dished out on the volley, so I'm going to swap that over. I've got a heavy laser now as well. That's going to recharge ever so slightly faster, but I'll switch it on. And what I will start doing is taking off auto fire, and then I'll do a volley of three and follow it with a heavy laser. And that should allow me to... Right. So I've got, should allow me to do more damage overall. Now, I've got at least two jumps here, so I'm going to get the quest. Oh, there we go. I found the missing cargo ship, docked to the rebel station, and I'm
attack the rebels!
Attack the rebels!
Rebel scum.
Oh, he's got a teleporter. We might get boarded.
Okay.
Oh, and there's danger from the planet. Oh,
they're
going to
be firing ion weapons at you.
Yeah, we're going to get... Right, we might see things come blowing through the hull of my ship from down below.
Oh, my God.
This is bad. This is bad news.
Red alert. Action stations, everyone.
I'm going to pause it because they're about to come in and do that. So I'm going to set my... let's see. What have they got? They've got that and that. That's not the end of the world. I think I need to...
take out their teleporter. Is that a resurrection bay they've got
that
there?
That is a resurrection bay as well, yeah. So if I kill them without that resurrection bay there, they won't be able to come back until it's repaired.
We need to just blow up their ship before that happens.
Yeah, I'm thinking...
Take out their weapons.
Yeah.
Right.
I'm thinking I'm going to set that there and watch them come onto my ship.
Yep.
There we go.
We've got one on board. It's just the one, and he's gone straight for weapons. Let him come into the weapons room.
Fine.
Let him come into the weapons room.
The mantis will kick his ass. You see that thing go past my ship?
It did. They missed.
From the floor.
Okay, first volley away. Alright, line up the heavy laser. Heavy laser's ready to go.
Okay, so first volley away and get that laser. Oh,
oh, he's just fired lasers at O2. You right, we've taken damage to the oxygen tanks.
Press the wrong one.
Oh, no.
Right, so...
Okay, the planet's about to fire at us. We got fires outside the oxygen room.
Yeah, that's fine, because we upgraded the oxygen room. It's okay, but we've got to put that now. Fire out.
Ah, we missed. Heavy laser's ready to fire. Take out weapons.
Come on.
It hit the shields. It hit the
shields. Come up again. Right,
all right, basic laser volley's building up. Ah,
oh,
we got a breach. Scoops needs to get out of there right now.
Yeah, he does.
Breach in weapons room.
Oh, dear.
We've lost some of the weapons. Some of the power's out of weapons.
Oh, and he's teleported back in as well. We're going to lose our weapons here.
No. Laser's coming in, but it missed. We got fire and note in the oxygen room.
Yeah, it's all going horribly wrong here.
we still got one weapon left, but it's only going to hit shields. We got another whole breach.
Oh my god.
On the right side of our ship.
Right, that's okay. The whole breach is
we got
fine
oxygen
there.
Back in the ship.
This guy's going to die.
He needs to get out of the weapons room.
Yeah. I know. Oh dear. This is going to get them all healed.
We're ready to jump.
Gonna get out, so they're gonna run in, they're gonna fix the weapons as quick as possible.
Oh, they just missed their missile.
And then, come on.
Okay, we've got another hull breach on the left side of the ship now.
Okay, so they're gonna get them healed again. That's fine. Hull breaches in spaces that don't matter, okay. Just need to fix these weapons.
This
so
laser's just
this
missed.
Guy.
We now have two weapons under control.
We've got one, two. Screw it.
Third level's ready. Auto fire all the time. Until it's really needed again.
Yeah. Alright, they fixed that.
Oh, we got another hull breach just outside the cockpit.
Was it right there as well? Right, okay, so he's going to go back to shields.
Hull is down to less than 50%, Captain.
It's okay. We're going to do him. Oh, why has that gone off?
We don't have enough power in weapons.
Oh, that's why. Right.
We're cruising the wrong locations.
Go.
Fire everything!
Alright,
we've taken his weapons down.
Now I'm going to take out his
shields. Got us locked on again. They missed.
See, my sinking is all out, so I'm going to wait for them to all...
Second hull breach.
Oh my god, look how much hammering
we And they've
we
just
get.
Fired another shot. And they just missed again.
Let's take him out quick.
We've got two more hits, one more hit. Yeah.
Come on!
Yeah, that should be it.
There we
nice. Go. Alright, we're still going to be taking hits from the planet here, though.
Yeah.
We've got two fuel, one missile.
Ship.
13 scrap! Oh my god.
Wow.
That's not going to get us repaired. Right, we've got to get out of here.
We've got to get back to the exit. Wow, I took a hammer in there.
We
it's
are
horrible
limping
when you get
away from
bombed
there.
From the ground. It's terrible. Right, so this is my chance now to repair myself up.
Yeah.
And fix some stuff. Now these are breached and they've got no oxygen in, so my guys are gonna health are gonna come down real fast.
Until they clear those breaches and get oxygen back in those rooms. I did figure out that if you open certain doors you could get oxygen into rooms faster.
You can.
You need to take care of that guy quickly.
Yeah,
wow.
He's fine,
almost
fine.
Killed him.
Nearly did. He's
and fine. Another one.
So yeah, I fixed, once
get me
you
worried.
Fixed, once you fix the
suffocating your crew.
Yeah, once you fix the breach, then you can allow oxygen into the room. But
yeah, but they might
door,
die as soon as they finish the breach still.
Yeah, yeah. If you open the door before the breach is fixed, all that will do is end up putting...
Taking the oxygen out of the next room?
Yeah, putting the every oxygen out of every room.
Yeah.
So you
one more
go,
breach to take care of.
I'm going to take both the humans because they're both best at fixing things.
Okay.
And I'm going to try and get them both.
So while that's
that
doing
one.
It, why don't you talk about the sound and the music of FTL, Geoff?
Yeah, it's kind of dinky, you know, kind of got all that like 8-bit sort of feel to it. But,
Really? I found the music to FTL absolutely hypnotizing.
I like it. Yeah, I'm not saying it's bad at all. It's kind of, it's just really endearing, and it will get in your head.
It's the perfect blend of science fiction. It reminds me of the music from like Mass Effect, and it's also the fact that the simple melody of FTL itself. I mean, you must have heard it over 125 times.
Yeah.
Because every time you die or it's game over and you come back to the main menu and it greets you with that opening simplistic sound score, and then you're just like, okay, one more game. And I have to say, the music to the game is fantastic. And when they updated the game again, they added even more music to it. And it is just spellbinding. I actually, when I was at work, I spent 2 hours at work just listening to the FTL soundtrack while I was working.
Wow.
Yeah, it was just mesmerizing, just to listen to.
So this is your little, so this is your roguelike map, really. These are the number of jumps it's going to take you to get.
Long way to go.
Yeah, it's going to take you to get to the end. That's where the boss will be. And these will always be different.
I suggest the civilian sector, and then we can head into some nebulas afterwards.
I really want some shops and some hull repair.
We really do.
So, new sector! Ba-ba-boom! And our ship is okay now. We've got our systems repaired.
But the hull is down to almost 25%.
And I've got to put him there, because he was shields, and he can go there.
So while we're flying around in this new civilian sector, Geoff, why don't you tell me, what's your favourite starship in movie history?
Yeah, well, that's a tricky one. See, I'm a big fan of the recent Star Citizen Kickstarter thing that's coming out, and they've had a lot of ships in there that seem to be inspired from old sci-fi movies. I think. So, yeah, I don't know if I can necessarily say the movies. I mean, you got the classic.
That was my question specifically.
You got the classic. What do you call them? The Klingon ships in
the Star Trek movies.
The Birds of Prey. I always thought they looked wicked, and they've also got the cloaking ability, which is just. I mean, it's just so cool. Nothing happened to this jump.
There's a store down there. We should probably head in that direction, roughly.
We definitely will. I'm just going to do a couple more jumps before I get there, try and maximise my scrap and hope I don't die.
So you're going to go with the Klingon Bird of Prey in Star Trek.
That was, certainly was one of my favourites when I was a kid.
In film.
Yeah, in film. Yeah, I think it has to be. Yeah, like the coolest looking design. They were pretty much badass. Oh, this guy's going to try and get away. And
he's going to try and run away. And he will probably warn the rebels of your location.
Oh, and he's actually... he will warn the rebels. And he's got this thing on which will allow him to sort of take out one of my systems. But that's okay.
So
I've taken out his engine.
I have a tie-in for two spaceships in film.
Yeah.
And well, the first one, obviously, it's got to be said, the Millennium Falcon. From Star Wars.
Oh yeah.
I mean, it's just when you see that ship, you know exactly what you're getting in for. You know you got Han Solo and Chewbacca, and the Millennium Falcon. It's invincible. It really is.
It is a fantastic ship. Yeah. I mean, like so unique in design as well. I quite like those really old design spaceships. I found that a lot of spaceships are beginning to become a little bit samey.
But my actual winner that I'm going to go for is going to... Just to cut you off, sorry.
Yeah.
Is the Sulaco from Aliens.
Ah, okay, the Sulaco.
Yeah. I love that design. It just looks like a giant pulse rifle in space.
It does. See, I really like the dropships from Aliens as well, even though they won't really fly very well because they're kind of a bit too square.
A bit clunky.
80s, yeah. But the... some of my favourite ships in gaming are clearly inspired by those ships, like the Halo dropship.
The Halo dropship, yep. I remember the first time I played Halo when I walked into the hangar bay, and I was just like, wow, this feels like I'm playing Aliens. Because especially with you've got the Black Sergeant with a cigar, and you've got all the recruits there, and then all the dropships. I was just like, wow, this is just... amazing.
Yeah. Very much you could tell there was definitely inspired by that.
Yeah.
And I think those 80s sci-fi films clearly are inspiring so much stuff that's sci-fi now. Right, looks like I've got to fight again. He was trying to hold me to ransom, so I was like, no.
Yep, we're not paying nothing, but, you know, we're down to about 15% hull.
He's got, we are. I'm going to have
to... On the brink.
I'm going to have to get him as quick as possible. I feel fairly safe. I think this thing just helps its shield or something. I'm not sure what that does. But...
So what would you say is your favourite sci-fi captain in film history?
Well, I mean, you've always got, you can never not think of Jean-Luc Picard whenever you think of any captains. And in the debate, oh, who's better, Picard or Kirk, I'm on the Picard side, I'm afraid. Just because I think he's more of leadership material, like the way he acts.
He's just more of a diplomat.
Well, yeah, but he's also a little more aloof. He's a little more how a leader generally tends to have to be, especially when you're making decisions in which people live or die. But then, I mean, there's that all sort of kind of theatrical gravitas, and Kirk's a bit more human, you know? I understand the debate and why you might be like, well, I don't know who's better. Now, I've hit jackpot here, boys. Wait, what have I got? I got the teleporter! Oh, wow. This is a huge... the teleporter 90. Is a big boon for getting scrap, because if you can take out all the crew of a ship instead of destroying it, you'll get a lot more scrap.
That's what I said earlier, yeah, but I am also letting you know that it's going to cost 42 scrap to fix the whole ship. So we're not going to be able to fix the whole ship here.
Nope, and
we could. We'd have two left over, but...
I am not going to even try to fix the whole
ship. We should probably sell our basic laser.
Yeah, because I'm going to sell that for a little extra. And then this is a scrap recovery arm, and this... Oh, that's very useful, that is.
Not usable right now, though.
The scrap recovery arm, which will also give me more scrap, so that'll
amplify. It's good very early on.
Yeah. But what I also want is
more crew, more weapons.
More crew. See the
rock
monster.
But we need
monster.
To fix the ship. Geoff, if we don't fix the ship, we're not going to even get very far.
Yep. See, these are the kind of decisions you got to make. I'm going to take the 10% extra scrap and fix myself twice. Yep. Scary, I know. Let's hope we can get some more crew. Right, so I'm gonna go to here.
And the shields better hold on this ship, because if we walk out onto the wrong deck, out in space we go.
That is a Mantis ship.
Well, it's only got one shield bar, so...
Now I'm gonna attack the pirate.
Going around provoking everyone today.
I am, yeah. I want all their scrap. All their scrap belong to us.
Well, we do have a teleporter now, but we've only got one Mantis, and he is our weapons expert.
So I'm going to take out the weapons, then I'm going to take out the med bay, then I'm going to teleport people over.
Okay.
So this is going to be an incremental thing.
It's a risky procedure here.
It is going to be a risky procedure. I'm even going to take out that, because you need to power the teleporter.
Yep.
So I'm going to do this. I'm going to try and hammer it as much as I can. I'm going to have to take one volley from his burst laser and get a bomb on board, probably, which is not good.
Shots are away.
Follow up with that one. Oh, I missed. That's not good. Right, so... And then I want that one on there like that. Let's do that. Now, one of the big things you want to take off auto fire if you're teleporting crew over there, because if you blow up the ship whilst there's people there... Oh!
They're about to concede 2 missiles, a drone, and 11 scrap.
They're about to give up. Now, I'm going to say... No! And I'm going to... I'm going to get rid of all my auto fire, because otherwise I'm going to blow up the ship.
Yep.
And then I'm going to get 2 guys in here. Like that.
Okay.
And then I'm going to press teleport.
Yep, it's ready to go.
And I'm going to teleport them into the med bay so they can't repair it.
Nice. And over they go. It's on
Which
fire.
Is on fire. That's not good.
No, because they're now burning.
Yeah.
Remember, if that ship takes any more damage, will they not accidentally blow up the ship that they're on, like they're doing
it
now?
Could do.
They're shooting the ship. Ooh. Alright, they've repaired the med bay.
Alright.
Which means
bad.
It's no longer on fire.
And that means, they're repairing themselves.
They have got weapons back online, though.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to get out of here, because I don't think I'm gonna be able to do it.
No, they needed some combat experience, which they did get. You've got no power in the med bay right now, remember?
No, I might be able to.
Weapons away, okay. So we got more scrap than yeah. And more. Well, they didn't offer any fuel, but we've taken it anyway.
And they've given me more. Been rewarded. More as well. Yeah, there you go. That's
rewarded
ideal.
For our efforts.
Whoop, whoop. Okay, so we got 42 scrap after that. Now I need to start thinking about upgrading some systems because I need at least one extra power. So that's going to cost me 20. If I increase that, that reduces the cooldown of how long it takes. And I'm going to need another shield thing by the time I get to the end of this sector.
And we're going to need to repair the hull.
And we're going to need to repair the hull very much so. So I'm going to jump to here first.
Okay. Minus four fuel for one truck. I don't think so. Let's get out of here. It's getting risky now.
I'm gonna have to go to the store first because I'm gonna get myself jammed down here.
Yeah, all of down there is cut off.
Yeah, so I'm gonna have to go to the store now, which is probably just gonna be a lesson in. Oh, look what you can't buy.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is real
burst
shame
lasers,
as well.
Ion blasters.
See, the burst laser is good.
Yeah,
but we're dreaming.
We just need to repair the hull. Don't sell anything.
It's worth 25.
It's not worth selling.
Okay.
Right, hull's now hull is now just past 50%. I'm happy now. I'll stop complaining about the hull until it goes back underneath 50.
We're back to 2/3 fixed in the hull.
Yeah.
And then that's going to keep me ahead of the rebels, so I'm going to start moving. You got to make tough choices in this sometimes.
You do. Attack the rebels! Or wait until the supplies from the civilians. Interesting moral dilemma has come
attack
back again.
Right.
Right, you've got crew and we need crewmen and shields. We also need power to the med bay to heal them. A few prep things we should have considered before launching into combat with the rebel disruptor.
That's fine. We've got just this ship for some reason is poorly equipped. It's got two lasers.
He's got a drone.
And lasers can't do anything to
unless he takes my shields down.
So they're not going to be able to take my shields down. So this is pretty much a freebie.
Okay. All your weapons are ready.
And what I'm going to do here is I'm not even going to shoot. I don't need to.
Okay.
There's nothing this ship can do to me. So this occasionally does that. What I'm going to do here is take it manually.
Nice.
So I'm going to jump into
it.
It doesn't have a med bay, so anything that happens here will stay done. They will get damage will stay done, and I can come back to them.
So you now have two on the timer countdown to bring them back.
I'm going to have to be pretty quick about it.
Yeah, because their health bars are sinking into the red.
Yeah, but they might be able to take
almost ready. Out. Now you can bring them back.
Right, that's it. Now looking, I'm going to have to bring it back. Cause that
and heal them up a little bit before sending them over to finish the job.
That's it.
So I'm gonna power off weapons.
I can take a power off there. That's
right. Power the med bay. Yep, get them in there. It's a good job it's right next door to it.
Yep.
You cannot get the choice of where you place the additional rooms you add to the ship. The game sort of adds them for you.
Yeah, it's kind of got set little places for them. Different layouts of different ships put them in different places.
Yep.
But there we go. They're all healed up and ready to go
Waiting on the countdown timer, and over they go.
And, there they go. So now I'm going to...
And considering they didn't have a med bay, this should be a pretty quick execution.
Yep. Especially with the Mantis there. There we
go.
Nice. Right. And... I'm going to take them all supplies. I need them all.
One drone and 13 scrap.
Nice. Okay, I'm going to be evil.
Bringing them back. Don't accidentally leave them behind.
Nope.
Send them to the med
that
bay.
That would be really silly.
And don't forget to send them to their actual stations.
Yep, that is also important. So there we go. Now they're back in there.
There is, just to point out, there is a couple of buttons just underneath the character names on the left side.
Yep.
So you can save your current crew positions, and there's a button to automatically send them.
That's right, yeah. That wasn't there when it first came out.
I'm absolutely sure it was. I've always used it for ease.
Okay.
Wow. Well, we are on the border.
We
could probably get two more jumps before the exit.
I could definitely get two more out, because the next jump will come to there. Yep. The next one will probably be just there, so I could go bomb, bomb, bomb.
Let's do it.
What do I get? Bomb, bomb, bomb.
Wow, to your core, but...
Yep.
both as random as each other, unless we get long-range scanners, which will tell us of possible catastrophes in the area, like ion storms and meteors.
We need sensors, okay, so we've got a teleporter on their ship.
So we should see if they teleport over here first.
Yeah, they will. Guaranteed.
There they come, and they... Okay, now...
There's only one of them, so I'm just gonna...
Now, what you can do, if you do upgrade the doors, you can seal the doors and then open certain doors and...
funnel them.
And funnel the enemies into certain rooms and flood the oxygen out of those rooms and suffocate the bastards.
Yeah. I'm gonna try and destroy his teleporter before he goes to teleport back as well, if I possibly can. Which I've done, so he's not getting back,
and he's dead.
So I'm going to put him there.
Excellent.
Right, now I'm just going to leave my... Oh, I'm going to put that on there. I'm going to leave that on there. And I'm going to get these guys ready to teleport over again, because this is good news. Oh, he's got this teleporter fix. I want to get down there before he fixes his weapons, though. Okay, I'm just going to kill these guys here in the weapons room.
I'm keeping an eye on their health bars.
Yeah, I'm going to have to get them running around the ship if they don't make it. But countdown time.
Yeah, they've done it.
They've done it. And I got some
24 scrap this time.
Scrap, yeah. Cool, okay.
Got two bonus scrap because of the scrap arm.
Let's get them back.
Back in the med bay.
Back in the med bay. What have we got here? Got distress signal there.
Yeah, we can probably hit the distress before the exit.
I'm gonna need shields for the next round, so I've got woefully bad weapons as well. This is not ideal, but at least I got the teleporter.
Yep.
So I'm gonna go in here. Let's go to the next distress beacon.
Okay.
I knew someone would fall into our dastardly trap. Well, you're in trouble now.
God damn it.
So, okay. I'm gonna take out their weapons again.
Power up the weapons.
Yeah, and then it's gonna be teleportation time.
So the thing that usually happens with me when I get to buy the teleporters, I usually end up coming across AI drone after AI drone. And of course, the first time I played it, I was like, yeah, I was gonna teleport over there anyway, and all my crew died. They just suffocated. I'm like, why don't they take, you know, O2 kind of... spacesuits.
Yeah, spacesuits.
I just don't understand
it. Good point. Where are the spacesuits? Well, you can get alien types in here which don't require oxygen.
That's true.
So they're your kind of best bet if you do.
You can also get assault drones as well.
Yes, you can as well. Yeah, they'll come over.
They're getting pretty banged up over there. They're in the red. They're in the red.
Oh, he just made it.
Look at that. New crew member.
Woohoo!
I called him a new crew member. You called him a prisoner.
Yeah, that's because I'm twisted. But my new crew member, there he is.
He's going to be our new repairman.
He becomes our new repairman, and he's going to work the shields. He's the man.
Okay.
Actually, he's going to work the weapons. And then Scoops can be here.
He can always be ready to go every time.
And he can actually go into here to give me an extra boost on my scanners, I think. Okay, so jump to the next one. Let's get out of here. Exit. We're doing okay for fuel. We've got missiles, but we've got no missile launcher. We've got drones, but no drones.
That's right. So it's okay right now. We're just collecting.
Another rebel checkpoint's monitoring location. So fend for yourself.
Fend for ourselves.
Escape. Stay quiet. Let's get them.
We're not trying to sneak past anybody.
Okay, so we've got... Now, see, because he's sat in there, the scanners, I can see who's inside now. He's got three crew members and a crappy laser and a fire... I think that's a fire laser beam, so I'm just going to take out their med bay.
Go for it.
And then go over there and kill them. Yeah.
That's a good plan. Okay, Geoff, well, this looks like an interesting space battle. But what is your favourite space battle in film? And then also in television?
Favourite space battle in film and television. There was a huge Babylon 5 battles, I remember, vaguely, thinking they were pretty epic with the big, like, streaming laser beams, you know, like...
I will confess that I have not watched Babylon 5. I've tried a couple of times. I've tried the first season. I watched an episode, and then a few years later, I tried an episode in season two, and I couldn't tell what was going on, and the sort of really bad special effects.
Yeah, there was
it kind of put me off a little bit. But I mean, I am accepting of bad special effects. I really liked Space Above and Beyond, and that for me was on par with Babylon 5 in terms of its special effects.
Yeah.
Especially with the space battles. So I have to say, I didn't get into Babylon 5, so I didn't see a single space battle or a single weapon get fired in the episodes I watched.
Ah, okay.
So you're saying Babylon 5 for your favorite TV battle? It's vague.
It's not favorite. It's worthy mention, but
worthy mention.
Yeah,
okay.
Worthy mention. Okay. But obviously Star Wars, man. Like, you just can't beat the
in,
epic.
In film, okay.
The epic battles
Star
Wars.
Yeah. Which one? Particular. Talking particulars here.
I think where they take on the Death Star.
Oh, in the first?
Where they actually blow it up.
Okay.
In the... is it the third one?
Return of the Jedi?
Return of the Jedi. They finally blow it up.
Episode 6.
Yeah, it's just brilliant. Brilliant. It's just so good. Okay, we're in a nebulous cloud now, so we can't... we can't see... Yeah, six.
Six,
isn't it?
Yeah.
We can't see what these locations produce, even if we had scanners. So I'm gonna go down here first.
See, I'm favorite TV sci-fi battles for me. I was gonna go to Star Trek for this one, and I'm torn between two in particular.
Yeah.
For me, the honorable mention, I think, is gonna have to go to the Battle of Wolf 359. Do you know what I'm talking about, Geoff?
No.
Is my geekdom coming through here?
Possibly.
The Battle of Wolf 359 was the first Federation versus Borg confrontation.
Oh, wow. Yeah,
it was also at the battle where Sisko's wife dies.
Yeah.
It was also, I think, Sisko's ship also got destroyed in that battle. And that was just before, obviously, Ben Sisko would go on to become the captain on Deep Space Nine.
Nice.
But in that encounter, so many Federation ships get blown up. And in Star Trek, you hardly ever see Federation starships exploding.
Yeah.
Unless they rewind time, or it's an alternate universe, or Q's just, messing with them.
Yeah.
So, and that moment in Star Trek history, it just kind of left an impact in every Star Trek episode since then. But that's my honorable mention. My actual favorite sci-fi space battle goes to Deep Space Nine,
right,
with the battle against the Dominion.
Okay.
When, I mean, I'd never seen anything like it. There was hundreds and hundreds of Federation ships on screen at one time.
Wow.
Blew my mind. But then you also had Romulan ships and Klingon ships versus the Dominion ships, and they're all going at it at the same time.
Ooh.
And when you're flying and following the Defiant around in that battle, just, yeah. I mean, it was a fair few episodes of the Dominion War, which I actually think went over a few seasons.
Yeah.
But I've also got to say, I mean, I feel like I've missed out on one of my all-time favorite sci-fi TV shows here.
Yeah.
And that's Battlestar Galactica. Now, Battlestar Galactica had a lot of good space battles and good scraps, but it weren't on those grand spectacles, because Battlestar Galactica is just the one spaceship. Now, at the very beginning of the series, I hate watching the pilot episode, because it's the moment when the Cylons just turn up and just absolutely lay waste to the human. The 13 colonies get absolutely annihilated.
Nuke everyone.
But it's because there's no space battle. There's no fight.
No, there's no fight.
The Cylons turn up and just deactivate every single human ship.
Yeah.
So they're just sitting ducks. It's not a space battle.
Thanks to guys.
A catastrophe. Well, yeah, thanks to guys. Boltar. And it can't be considered a space battle. And I will say that some of the space battles are intense, because you know that the Galactica and at one point, the Pegasus,
yep.
are the last two human starships in existence.
Yeah.
So you do feel the tension whenever they go into combat, but they're just not on the scale of perhaps the Star Trek ones.
Yeah, I think that's fair. I have failed to upgrade my ship. I'm going to attempt to remain concealed. Never noticed me. Okay,
managed
so
to
I'm
sneak
gonna,
past them.
Yep, yeah, I'm going to have to.
We've got 206 scrap now, Geoff.
Taking the action of getting myself the extra shield system. It's very important I do get that because he's got two shields as well. Really do need to find myself some decent weapons now.
There's a store.
Perhaps should have upgraded my shields afterwards, but I do need those shields. Okay. Right, we've got cloaking, which is incredibly powerful.
And very expensive.
Yeah, location scanner. It's very good.
Missile it's good for our teleporting teams to know what they're getting themselves into.
It is indeed, especially when you're stuck in a nebulous cloud like this and your scanners don't work. However, it's not that important. And I've kind of not really got much luck with this one. And there's nothing here I desperately need.
I've got nothing worth selling, so perhaps fix the hull?
No, I'm even going to save the hull. I could go mind control.
Mind control is always interesting, but...
Or I could go defense drone. Defense drones are fantastic for taking out missiles incoming.
Yeah, because they bypass shields.
Yeah.
I'm with you on some drone control. We've got 10 drones in the armory.
But I can only have so many systems. So I can have another 2 systems. So I will sacrifice the ability to have some of the more powerful systems if I go for the drone ones. Now, cloaking is incredibly powerful, but I can't quite get it right now. So what cloaking allow you to do is allow you to get all your weapons up to maximum before you
whilst the enemy cannot lock onto you.
So.
I found it very useful, especially with the end boss.
That's my crew. So store, and I'm just gonna add a couple of fixings. I'm not gonna go too mad on it.
I approve.
Keep the 100.
Okay.
And try and get something even better in a bit because I want some really big guns.
Yeah, back into the nebula.
Yep, now I've got the exit down here. I can reach it from that point there, so I'm going to come up this way and then move down.
Okay.
Nothing. Nothing
the
here.
The tension is almost palpable as nothing happens.
Yep. And down to this one.
So what's your favourite sci-fi TV show, Geoff? In general, doesn't have to be space related, just sci-fi.
Yeah. That's a good question. I don't know. I couldn't really pick a favorite, I don't think. TV shows were always quite a bit lower budget, weren't they? So, let me think.
I'd be lying to myself if I did not say Battlestar Galactica.
Yeah.
As a child, I loved the original series.
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't a fan of Galactica 1980.
Yeah.
Always loved watching the original 3-hour, 2-hour movie of Battlestar Galactica.
Mm-hmm.
And the reboot series by Ron Moore absolutely blew my mind. I was a late comer to the show. I think when I first started watching it, it was already into its third season.
Mm-hmm.
But I binged watched the first 2 seasons in a couple of weeks and was just ranting and raving to everybody that I came into contact with about this show.
Of course, yeah.
And it was absolutely fantastic. I know it has a lot of haters, and I know a lot of people switched off to it, and I know that there's still a lot of fans of the original show. I've got to say, I am a fan of the original show.
Yeah.
And But I'd love the reboot show, and it was a fantastic run.
I suppose Star Trek Next Generation is perhaps the most inspiring out of all of them.
I'd agree with that. I mean, I have to say Ron Moore actually worked on a lot of Star Trek The Next Generation, an awful lot on Deep Space Nine, and about 2 episodes, I think, of Enterprise.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I liked the way that they sort of mix a little bit of philosophy and, kind of all that kind of thing into the adventuring of it. And there's never been a sci-fi film or series or like sci-fi intellectual property that has been so prophetic with respect to the way technology could go, you know?
Yeah. Where's my holodeck?
Yeah, it's not far off, you know? Like, once upon a time, we believed we couldn't bend light and do things with light that the sci-fi, you know, Star Trek suggested was possible. But they're slowly but surely finding out that we can manipulate light like that. And things like warp drive as well, shrinking space in front of you in order to move through it faster. All these things are becoming a physical reality. Now, this is, we're getting into some big badass ships here. This guy's a badass.
Wow. He's got quite a crew as well.
Flat gun as well, which will destroy my shields. He's got a hell of a crew. He's also got a defense drone, so I don't really want to go over there and try.
He's got three shields as well.
Take him out. Yeah. So yeah, this guy's going to be a tough guy. I don't even know if I'm going to get through him.
I can hear the music in the background, and it's so tranquil. You wouldn't believe that there's an epic space battle.
I got a horrible feeling like I'm not going to be able to get through these shields.
Yeah, okay, we're taking damage. The weapon's captured.
Yeah, I'm going to have to get out of here. That's all I can do.
Power to engines and let's bug out.
Just jump. This guy's hard.
Yep, shields taking hits. Shots away. We're missing shots.
It's those flat cannons that are just so devastating. Right, so if I put more power to engines, then the FTL drive will spool up quicker.
Yep.
And it's merely a case of, like, I gotta get out of here because I can't take this guy.
Well, we've not taken too much more hits yet, but...
See how sometimes you can... you can take ships and you're just vastly superior to them, and sometimes you meet something and you're just
We are in a new zone now.
So yeah, I'm gonna go for the distress beacon.
We're in sector 4, so it is gonna start getting more difficult.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I cannot afford to give them 4 fuel, really.
No, because we'd be down to a bare minimum.
Oh, yeah, that's the problem.
So we're just gonna feed them to the rebels.
Yep.
Yeah, we'll send someone to help you. They'll be here in about 4 turns.
Yep, 4 light years.
Yeah.
Okay, I've got an injured guy here. There's still nothing. Oh dear, I could end up running out of fuel, you know? This isn't good.
Oh, no.
Alright, he needs fixing. Get him fixed.
Yep.
There we go. And get back over here.
Hover near the exit. Hopefully find another store. I ate the civilian ship. We can take on the Mantis. They've got 2 Mantis
indeed
over there. And 1 healing guy. I've forgotten what that alien race is called.
The NG.
NG, yeah.
Yeah, he's the engineer guy. I'm going to take one off there, put that on there.
Yeah.
And
destroy
he's
their
not
med
got
bay.
A teleporter. Weapons first.
He's
so
got 3 shields, mind you. So you're going to need to fire all your weapons.
Oh, shit. So they have.
I think this is going to be commonplace now for this section. Sector 4.
Yeah.
Well, at least you got a hit in this time.
I did, which means the shield's down 1.
I'm guessing our pilots are doing better.
I'm gonna keep hammering that.
Which leads me to another question for you, Geoff.
Haha!
Your favourite pilot?
In sci-fi,
yeah. So I'm just chucking up some nominations now. I mean, you've got Starbuck in original Battlestar, and then you've got female Starbuck in Battlestar Galactica.
Yeah.
I mean, you got Han Solo with the Millennium Falcon. He's a pilot.
Yeah.
You've got who flies the Enterprise?
Is it
Data or is it?
Well, it's a combo, isn't it? It's a 2-man job.
Yeah,
I believe.
You got tactical, and then you've got the helmsman.
You had that student guy in.
Oh, Wesley was sat there for a while.
Yeah, he was pilot.
But then, of course, you always had Sulu.
I don't think I'm gonna be able to take this.
And Chekhov. In Enterprise. I mean, you've also got Tom Paris, who actually broke the faster-than-light 10 barrier.
Yeah.
Which meant that he was traveling at infinite velocity.
Wow.
So, exactly, which meant that he was at every point in the universe at once.
Yeah.
Exactly. I watched a lot of Voyager. I mean, I never watched it all.
Yeah.
I watched, like, the first 3 or 4 seasons, and then I came back for the last season. Just to see how it all ended. And there was an episode where, they broke that barrier. And do you even know what happens? When he breaks that barrier,
yeah,
he ends up... You remember The Fly with Jeff Goldblum, where he starts to mutate?
Yeah.
That's what happens to Tom Paris. He starts to mutate, and and apparently the Doctor calls it evolution.
Yeah.
But he sort of de-evolves into, like, a fish creature.
Oh, dear.
Yeah. But then, you know, they medicate him and decide that he's okay and decide not to use the technology that he's just discovered.
Nice.
But, I mean, sorry to sidetrack on crazy pilots,
that's
but...
Right, yeah.
You've also, I mean, you've got all of the different pilots of the Defiant in Deep Space Nine.
Put them in a really bad place.
But I'm going to tell you who my favorite pilot is in sci-fi. It's Wash from Firefly, from Serenity.
Yeah?
Yeah. Favorite pilot, best pilot, Leaf on the Wind.
Oh, Serenity. Yeah, of course, yeah. Serenity's fantastic, isn't it? It's such a good... Whee! Got a Hermes missile, finally.
Nice.
Right,
we got 24 of those bad boys.
We do, but we've only got 3 fuel. There's a risk here. We're just going to run out of fuel.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to make sure I buy some if I do find a shop. We've currently got an ion pulse going at the moment as well.
Which is taking out our shields.
Yeah.
And it's taking out, yeah, shields, weapons,
everything
teleporters.
At the moment. So I need to get out of here. There's the storm.
Excellent. Let's get out of here.
Well, at least I can get some fuel and repair.
Fuel is a priority. It's
okay.
Expensive, but we need some.
It is indeed. Very
it is.
Much
yeah.
We need some. No weapons again.
No. Mind
no
control's there.
Again.
Cloaking's there. It's 150.
I'm just going to have to commit to the
yeah.
fuel.
Yep. We're going to be left high and dry in the next sector.
And what I'm going to do
we
now
we could equip
is...
the Hermes and then sell another
basic
laser.
I'm going to get the cloaking because it's just within reach. So if I... What's the Hermes there? It's... Free power! Oh my god!
We need power to the ship. That means
we're
not going to have enough power.
Yeah, not to power. So I could, but it will mean that what I can do is put all power to the Hermes and then put the lasers on. So I can use the Hermes to get past the shields.
Yeah.
Take out whatever systems I want.
Yeah.
And the heavy laser is not that good, but I will get a fair amount of money for it. So.
Back to the store.
Yeah, back to the store. And so I'm going to sell that.
I hope you know what you're doing.
And get the cloaking, because that's going to be much more powerful.
Okay.
I would love that fire suppression, but I'm just not going to be able to afford that.
Not this time.
Oh, look at that.
That's
another
not worth going
store.
Down there, is it? You could go up and then circle back. Yeah, it's true, but we can't afford anything now.
No, that's it.
We're committed to the fuel and to the cloak.
And I really...
Demand their surrender!
Right, okay.
It's the rebels. They're charging FTLs, yep.
Right, so put the Hermes on.
Just want to report that we do have some damage to the oxygen reserves.
We do, don't we? So I'm going to put him there because I'm going to cloak.
Nice.
And I'm going to. That gives my Hermes a chance to.
Power up.
Power
and
up.
We're going to take down. He could. Could he shoot down your Hermes? He does
he
have
could,
a drone.
Yes, he could.
Shots fired.
Is it?
And it got through, but it hit his shield.
What? Oh, he's got a Zoltan shield.
Yeah. So
and that's what that does.
Yeah, and another Hermes missile is just going to be wasted on that shield, so...
I'm going to send
you've
it anyway.
You've already fired it.
Yeah.
Okay, his lasers
actually,
is doing nothing, but he's
do
taken
that.
Down your cloak.
Let's put that basic laser on, and then...
Start, yeah, exactly. Otherwise, you're wasting missiles on his.
Weaken the Zoltan shield.
Yeah.
And then follow up with the Hermes.
He jumped.
Oh, he's gone.
Alright, this is bad news because I think the fleet marker.
Who's now going to be right on us.
Well, it looks like we still got chance for one more spot.
Yeah, let's go get one more spot. Oh, now this could be good or bad. I'm going to pry it. Open. Yeah, we got a new crew member.
Excellent. We've got
and
we now have
mantis.
Two mantis who I believe are the best ones to send in on
definitely
kill missions.
They are them and the rock people.
Yeah.
Actually, I slightly prefer the rock people, and you know why?
They've got more health
is because
and they're immune to fire.
That's it. Yeah, you can set them scrapping in a fiery room and then that will just waste people because they're having to fight you whilst burning alive. Brilliant.
Any reward for getting here? It's a trade.
So I can trade that for drones.
Prove the reactor. 3 missiles, 2 drones.
Yeah.
We don't have drones. You did it?
Oh, improve the reactor. No, yeah. Not for 3 missiles, 2 drones. That's expensive.
Okay.
Okay, so next sector. NG.
Oh, we're past the halfway point now. We're flying. We're making some distance.
Okay, so we're now in NG space. And we've got a store straight away.
I'm flying right past it.
Boosh. I'm just going to, fly right past it with no scrap.
I hope for another store in sight. Mind you,
fuel.
That's exactly what I was going to say.
Yes.
Yes, why not? I'm looking for a less incompetent captain to investigate.
I accept.
A quest marker. Right. Okay, where is it? Oh.
Next jump.
Hopefully they got some fuel over there.
I'm going to go there and then come back.
Yeah.
Come back down. Oh,
we're in the red for fuel.
Yeah, we are.
Oh, what have we got here?
We found ourselves pirate. Which
well,
is
there's two crewmen,
really
and it
easy.
Looks like they don't have a med bay. Oh, but they've teleported over.
Oh, they got a mind control.
Ah, okay.
So I'm going to cloak, and I'm going to send them over into his shield there.
Nice.
Hopefully that'll take these guys out real quick. My mind control guy might damage my shields a bit, but it's not going to be the end of the world.
No, you can repair that afterwards.
This might hurt. That burst laser might hurt a little bit, but see what happens.
Well, hopefully you can take him out quickly. And we got some fuel out of it.
Got loads of stuff out of it. Brilliant.
All right, bring him back.
Bring him back. Send him to the med bay.
Med bay needs power.
Med bay does need power. Here we go. So does my
shield. Yep, get that second shield up. Never going to get over there. You're never going to see that store.
Yep, so I'm going to add another power bar, which is now costing me 25 a pop. That means all my systems can have power.
Excellent.
And I'm going to come back this way.
As you can see, it's absolutely ideal to take over enemy ships. You get so much more scrap. I mean, you might not have got any fuel if you'd just blown it up.
Yeah. Now I've got a Mantis just jumped on with me, and I can side with the fugitive and fight the NG, or offer up that Mantis in exchange for a bounty. Now, I don't really need any more crew members, but they can die.
That's true.
And I could just blow up the NG ship and take it.
We're
so
in NG space. Ah! We just took some damage.
It was a trap! He stitched me up and the NG's coming for me.
Yeah.
And he's done my teleporter.
I said we should have just given up the bounty.
Right, he's got a defense
We're
strain.
In NG space, you know?
That Hermes isn't going to get through either.
And this is just a scout ship.
Oh, God. What are we going to do? Right. They've got
power to engines.
Guns. Yep.
And
so.
GTFO.
I'm going to have to try and get through their defenses somehow. Well, power to engines. Let's just get out of here.
Yep. Those mantis are going to take a while to... Oh, they actually rebuilt the teleporter.
Ooh, they all missed.
That's coming down to the piloting skills.
Yeah. I could just spend the teleporter. I got 3 mantises in there and a med bay though. That's bad news. Alright, let's see if I can destroy that. Let's see if I can dish out
anything
back.
More and more complicated
now. Yeah, cloak again, that'll help me. Like, because they can't lock on to me when I'm cloaked.
No.
Got very short cloak time though, I need to upgrade that.
Yeah. Well, shields are holding. We're repairing shields as quickly as they're bringing them down.
We're doing okay. I'm getting out of here because that's not going to work.
There's another store. We need it for fuel. We just need to spend up on fuel.
We do,
it's an emergency again.
I bet there's going to be a lovely weapon there as well.
Probably.
Look at that! Oh, you bastards.
It's just a tease.
They're not that good.
We're not even close to having enough money.
Oh, long range scanner.
We're dreaming. We don't have enough scrap. We need to buy fuel.
1, 2, 3.
That's it, and repair the ship a little bit. Or save the money. But we can't afford anything here.
30, that's all.
You shouldn't even look at it.
So tempted.
Sell the Hermes?
Yeah. It's not that good of a gun, that's the problem. It takes up too much power. Long range scanners. Going to be more useful.
You're getting rid of missiles for scanners.
I am getting rid of missiles for scanners.
As the the fighting gets more complicated.
Yeah. we definitely need a weapon upgrade, but that I'm gonna have to.
Okay.
Find a way.
Okay, we've got a Mantis scout ship, and there are four Mantis on board that ship.
Four Mantises.
And we got two to send over. They don't have a med bay.
Their guns are not terrible.
If our teleporter was only better, we could send them in and back again before they would be in too much trouble.
I'm going to let them...
We haven't got weapons that target enemy crew, so... And now we only have three basic lasers to fight their three shield spots.
Which won't happen.
I'm going to say that this is going to be a battle of attrition. These guys... What are their combat experience? You can actually have a look at their statistics.
Yeah, they've got a fair...
They've actually got some...
Well, he's not.
No. But he's that might carry the fight long enough to be able to teleport them back afterwards. But it's a tough. You're fighting more other Mantis.
What I can do is, what you can do is just start running around like Benny Hill it for a minute, and then until it comes back. I'm going to risk it. Here we go. They're going to come and teleport over here. Except.
Yep, they've come over. And, okay, so if... Yeah, we still haven't upgraded the doors yet.
No. They're going to come... That's okay.
And they're going to take down the doors. It's not a major system.
It is not a major system. I'm not too worried about that. I'm mostly worried about these two guys surviving.
They're doing okay.
Enough.
They're doing okay. They're actually destroying those over there. Okay, we have... Okay, now they're taking hits. But they should be okay. They should be able to kill everything that's over there. Okay. Pretty sure.
Just.
To the wire. But our teleporters are now taking damage. We can't bring them back. I would have them destroy the enemy's teleporters. On the other ship.
Yep, that's a good idea.
So that they can't teleport back either. Okay, we've taken a string of damage there. Shield's going to be a little while going back up.
Yeah, I'm going to have to run out here and they're going to get my oxygen. I know
they are. That's okay. If they take oxygen, you can just send them into the med bay for a minute.
Yeah.
Let them hit oxygen and then bring them back in again.
Yeah. I need that repairing, so the NG's going to repair that.
Yeah, don't need anyone on weapons control.
No.
The pilot's still needed to evade their shots occasionally.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they're ready to go back in the fight.
One of them is, but I don't want to send them both in with one in, because you'll get
hammered. Yeah, two on one.
Oh shit, I'm taking shots far from that as well.
Sooner we kill them, it's over. They've gone into the teleporters, and they're not attacking. Yes they are, there we go. Still can't bring them back yet, can we?
Into the med bay.
That's excellent.
So they'll get swapped and we should
right,
be
shields
able to get
back
this.
Up now. Shields are back up.
Yeah.
And this will finish the fight. We need to repair the oxygen tanks next. Priority. Nice.
Should take these out.
Okay, they did just fire a volley of shots, though.
It might hurt.
Three fuel, excellent.
Just what we needed.
And they missed.
Sweet!
Some hit the shields, but I will say we are down to less than a third hull.
That hurt a lot, that did. And they did do a lot of damage while we were making that fight happen. But it's okay, we're gonna get them. Right, so...
Sensors, he brought sensors!
Gonna have to heal everybody up. You can fix that NG. Make sure we've got a fully repaired ship before we go back in.
Yep.
Alright, so Bjorn was doing shields. Butters was doing...
Not a lot.
Butters was doing repairing. He's in there now. And NG.
And the NG, what was he doing? That was our weapons. Yep.
And
our pilot needs to get back into the bridge.
Fleishy needs to get back on the bridge. Yep. Okay, we got everybody healed back up.
Everybody's ready to go.
And I'll put him back there, then save all their positions.
Yep. And jump. Distress and a store. Well, the store's on the way to the exit. I'm going to suggest the store now because we're so close to being dead. If we jump into a shit zone...
I'm gonna take the distress.
Oh
first.
No! No.
Gotta take
risks. What happened at the last place we went to? It was a trap.
Oh, giant alien spiders are no juke. Yeah. Joke.
They're no juke. I'm not joking with you either. You just did it, didn't you?
We did it. Contact the station owners. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Woo-hoo! All right. Your gamble paid off this time.
Yeah, this game is one big gamble. You'll be sweating every time you click the button.
Because you'll play it through one time, and it's like, oh, you know, giant alien spiders, and you take the gamble, and you're like, yeah, fight the spiders, and you get the victory.
Boom!
S'more
right,
bombs,
we
Vulcans.
Have got the Vulcan cannon. This is a beast. Bought, ooh. Purchased, purchased. Right.
Does it fire death pinches?
Like spools up, and once it's going, it's like pew 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 pew. Kicks ass.
Okay.
So that's gonna take all my
power,
and what I'm gonna do is just sell all these.
Really?
Yep.
They're
not any good anymore. No use to me. So
I will say you have sold more weapons than you have purchased.
Yeah, you will see that. It will be useful.
Fuel tanks are feeling healthier than they have done in a while.
Yeah, and the rest is just going on.
Fixing up the ship. Okay. Just over a third now.
Yeah.
A little bit better.
We got the Vulcan.
Need power.
More power.
Yeah. Taking some from engines.
Yeah. So, we've got possible ship. Possible ship. I got one.
That's the distress has gotten.
I reckon I can do three more jumps. So I'm going to go
up and then down and then down to the exit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, let's aid the civilian ship. We're in a better position now.
Okay.
It's another Mantis ship, and there's two Mantis on board. One Engi, and they're heading to their teleporters straight away.
Yep, that's okay. They can come and fight my guys.
They've got a cloning bay, they don't have a med bay.
They do, so when they die, they will just come back.
Yep, it's just one Mantis that's come over.
Yeah.
I say, you could probably kill him and then head over there and start on the cloning bay.
I could, yeah. I'm going to quickly heal these guys up. The Vulcan cannon will start cranking up. The difficulty when you're shooting stuff with the Vulcan cannon.
Oh,
he's just bombed me.
We were not going to be cloaking anytime soon. Yeah, that bomb bypassed the shields. And he's just resurrected his Mantis.
Yeah, so I'm going to change the direction of the Vulcan cannon onto that. I'm going to get these guys in here because they need to put that out.
Yep. Or you could just open a couple of doors and vent the fire.
Could do, yeah, that's a good point. But they're going to do
it. It's just been hit again and they've taken some damage at being in the room.
Yeah.
They do have the enemy Mantis has just come on board and he's hitting doors. We now have a fire in the adjoining room.
Yeah.
Okay, enemies weapons are down.
And no, his cloak bay's out, but now I'm gonna direct that towards the weapons.
Oh right, yep.
Now there's a strong possibility here that they're just gonna.
Yeah, they're continuing to fire at you, but that enemy Mantis is over here. He's hitting oxygen tanks right now.
I cannot open the doors. So.
Nope, that's because the door's control's been taken out.
Mm-hmm. Taking out their weapons
slowly but surely. Yeah, that Vulcan cannon's at full firing capacity now, so it is, as you were saying, going pew pew.
Pew pew. It's keeping their shields down.
But we've just taken Vulcan cannon's offline. We've just taken a hit to the weapons.
Right.
Spoke too soon. Now we got a raging fire
at
the central part of the ship.
Yeah.
Oxygen tanks are down.
He's got to fix
doors
that.
Control and sensors are down.
Yeah, so it's all panic stations here. And my guns are down.
Weapon power. You can put power back into weapons. You can put power, but it's got to charge up again.
Yeah.
All right. We've got Butters and Shiri are in trouble. They need healing.
Yeah. So coming on down, and this guy is come on, put the fire out.
He's not the best equipped to be putting out fires.
This guy needs to heal himself.
Okay. The Vulcan cannon is starting to power up again.
And yeah. What am I doing?
No, he hasn't put. Ah, the fire spread. He's going to take double damage in there now.
Boom. Get another guy in there. He's going to go and fix that. And he's going to come in and replace him.
Okay.
So they should fix this pretty quickly. We're Vulcan cannon spooling up again. Need to hammer those. I might just put it on weapons, actually. go, and that's fixed. So that needs to go back to there. Butters. Oh, actually, I'll just do that.
Okay. I would.
I'm gonna commit to killing him.
Yeah, I was gonna say your Vulcan cannon's powered up enough. If you were to send anyone over there,
yeah, it'd be very dangerous.
Yeah.
So we got a decent amount of scrap.
And the civilians got away.
Ran away.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh well, fair enough. Job done.
Yep.
And one, two.
It's gonna be risky. If you take the middle one on the way down.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to get that one.
Yep.
I should have fixed my oxygen before I went on there as well. Which I'm gonna do with the NG and make sure everybody's healed up. Butters, you gotta come in here. See how much quicker the NG repairs the OT.
So much faster than the Mantis.
Yeah. And you're back to weapons and.
And to the exit. No, no, well, we could probably get that one and then jump back. Hopefully it's just not a dead spot. Something interesting happens.
Yeah, otherwise wasted fuel. Ooh,
it's a fueling platform.
Fueling platform.
Oh my god, another trap. I hate to say it, Captain, but we are under a third hull.
Yeah. These guys are not.
I also want to say engines have been taken out.
Ah, so we're not even going to be spooling up.
We're not even spooling up FTL.
Well, I'm gonna.
He does have a med bay.
Yeah, I'm gonna take out that med bay.
It's
gonna...
looks like a mainly Engi ship.
It's a Mantis ship, that one is, but it's mostly. There's two Engis and two Zoltans on it.
Okay. Zoltans are pretty weak in combat, but if I'm not right, didn't know that. Are they the alien race that explode when they die?
They do. So if you're on really weak health when you kill them, they're just gonna blow you up. So, yeah, you gotta be
okay,
very careful.
Okay, O2's been taken out. It's temporary, but
temporary,
so is...
Yeah, that's fine. It's just one of those. Right, so...
We are hitting there. We are shooting that ship, yeah.
Keeps missing, but...
Yeah, our cloak's ready, but it's powered up to maximum now, the Vulcan cannon.
Come on, cannon.
Starting to hit. Its shields are taking serious damage now.
Right, so now I'm going to jump these guys into here.
Okay. The Vulcan cannon's still firing.
Yeah, it's fine. I keep that. Okay, so pause that. We'll run them into there so that doesn't.
So that they can't repair
it. Yeah.
And heal.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to be careful. That Zoltan's
okay,
gonna blow
they
up.
Just got a round in that hit.
That's okay. Now we're gonna kill that NG.
The only other thing I always fear is that the enemy ship will just jump away.
Yeah. Well, it will tell you if they start spooling up their drive.
That's right. Doesn't just automatically do it, but I have lost crew that way before.
Yeah, no, this is going to be too dangerous to kill those with that Zoltan there.
Yeah,
so I'm going to
take in some damage.
I'm
going to... Could just cloak quickly. Or stay heal.
There. Yeah, I'm going to cloak now. Yeah, that bomb missed me.
Mate, they are repairing the med bay. We've still got a cooldown on the teleporter, though.
Yeah, I'm going to have to just heal them up once the cooldown on the teleporter.
Yeah,
they
fixed
bay.
It.
Vulcan hopefully
it's okay, it's
down
not
again.
Totally fit. Okay, now they're healed.
Yeah. That's okay. We'll do the same thing again, same procedure, get the med bay down, jump into the med bay, kill them both, and then we'll be done.
I'm with you unless the OTS Enterprise takes another hit.
Yeah, it's dangerous, it is dangerous, but we'll be okay. I think we've got this down. Right, come on, Vulcan cannon. Ah, it's fucking stopped
Looks
again.
Like it's just woken up. And they just bombed over into a non-important section of the ship.
Good.
And every shot missed. Of course, we were cloaked. And we just missed as well with the Vulcan cannon, but it's only just spooling up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it takes rather a bit long, this Vulcan cannon, but in conjunction with other things, it's so powerful. Especially because it keeps on firing once it's spooled right up, and keeps those shields down, so then when your other weapons charge up, they're just open. Okay, so we've got a fully charged Vulcan cannon. And
plowing away at their med bay. It's taking damage. It's red. And they offer surrender for 3 fuel, 1 drone part, and 24
that's
scrap.
That's quite a good offer. That is quite a good
technically
offer.
Technically be 26 scrap when you take it.
Ooh, but I could just kill them now. They're totally vulnerable. I'm going to take
it. You're going to take it. Yep. You're going to annihilate them.
Yep.
Okay.
I'm going to annihilate
away
them.
Away team over.
Totally immoral. This is space war.
It is. It's survival of the fittest. God damn it! Just took another hit to the hull.
Yeah. There we go. We got more scrap out of that.
That's true. No, 48.
He just
leveled up to gold level combat, which is going to make him absolutely ideal for away missions now.
Badass.
Yeah.
Okay, so we need to get to...
Well, I guess they won't be jumping over onto one of these ships.
No, they will not. So
it's got no shields, and it's only got one weapon bay. Your Vulcan cannon... just cloak, yep.
I'm going to cloak with you.
You'll probably decloak first.
Possibly. Might be the same.
His cloaking device is better.
Yeah.
Now he's powering up his weapons and locking on.
Yeah.
He's still cloaked. Wow.
He's got a maximum cloak, that is.
Okay. Well, he took up all that time to fire off that and... Oh!
Oh! There's a powerful shield.
Shields are taking damage, medbay's taking damage, and our hull is down to 5 bars.
I'm gonna hide for a second and put my shields back up.
We missed his weapons!
Shields back up.
He's cloaked again.
He's annoying. He is annoying. I'm gonna hopefully get my cloak back up.
Any second. Like 5 seconds.
As soon as he fires, he's gonna come out of cloak anyway, so I'm gonna...
That's fine. Okay, yeah, his laser did nothing. Yeah. And we missed again. Well, it's been a while. The Vulcan has not had a chance to fully... There we go.
That's ideal.
Just took a little while because of all the cloaking. But now look at it go.
Now look at it go.
He's not going to return another shot.
He's not. That's it. He's gone.
Yep. Sweet!
Just need to get some hull repair badly.
Seriously. Woohoo! Yep.
No, got loads of scrap, though.
Jump into the next
as
sector
as
now.
As we can make it, I'm going to go safe with the civvy sector.
Yep, wise choice.
Oh, come on, shop. Come on, shop. Got some decent scrap.
There's a store right there.
Yeah!
Ideal.
Boom! Right. And we have got...
Let's see, we... Fix all. Yep.
And I'm going to buy a little more fuel to guarantee myself.
We could get the drone control. We've got 15 of them, and what is the drone you get with it this time round?
I'll get a combat drone Mark 1. Mm. Is the defense drones that...
Well, you wouldn't be able to afford any one of those.
No.
If you brought it.
No.
I haven't got much left to sell, Geoff. You've sold pretty much everything else.
Yes, there's nothing else I really want to sell, and I don't know about the drone control. Do I want it? I'm going to take it.
I would. I usually take drone control when I can.
I'm
going
to try and get...
I need some more power into it. Oh, you got an achievement.
Full arsenal? What? I thought we already had that. So I'm going to try and... Oh, do I come back down here? That's going to be... Yeah, I'm going to go around the top.
Okay. Looks like one of our Engi needs a little bit of medicating.
Yes. Anyone would. There we go. Get some heels.
And back. And jump.
Let's jump.
This uneventful trek through Sector 5. Offer your help.
And we've got a quest mark.
New quest. Just happens to be all the way over there. It's reachable to get to the exit from over there.
Yes, I'm going to come down to here. It. Ooh,
wow.
Got a pirate ship.
It's got a Zoltan shield.
Shield as well. But once I'm past the Zoltan shield, I can teleport over. Okay, so I'm gonna aim for that aim for the weapon bay first.
Okay.
Try and take out those missiles because that's bad.
I knew it was too good to last.
So
we were brand spanking new. We were just out of dry dock.
Yeah.
And we got a whole breach at the door control bay. Whew, that was one hell of a barrage of shots he just let go.
Yeah.
Cloaked just in time.
Big old fat burster.
And, nice piloting. We've just managed to dodge that missile.
Vulcan's spooling up, so hopefully that will start hammering them now.
Another missile come in. Oxygen tanks have been destroyed.
That's not good.
We are losing oxygen.
Yeah. Well. I'm gonna have to fix that. might just end
up killing. Ah, we have lost engines and we are out of oxygen. Yeah. And we're down to 75% hull.
It's okay, it's okay. I think they're going to die now.
I think your Vulcan cannon's going to get them, but we have got nothing repaired on oxygen. We're down to 65% oxygen on the ship.
Come on, come on. Fix that oxygen.
Oxygen has been repaired.
Oh, sweet.
And engines have almost been repaired. Well, we do have jump capabilities, and now I think we're overcoming the enemy.
And I think what I'm going to do now is go for the...
You're going to teleport over there now?
Yep.
The ship's nearly destroyed, though.
It's fine.
You're not firing?
I took the cannon off, yeah. And these two mantis will take out these guys real quick and easy. Although the rock monster's a little bit tough.
Yep. Taking a bit of damage, but he just got some combat experience.
Oh, shit. There's another mantis in there. That's not good. And they've still got a cloak machine as well.
And you don't have the ability. You got about 5 seconds before you, 4 seconds before you can teleport them out.
Yeah. So I'm gonna have to start running around.
Yeah.
Forgot they got a cloaker.
Okay, about 2 seconds before you can cloak get them out.
Yeah.
Now. Are they in the same room together? Yeah. They're back. Okay,
so I'm just going to have to continue to hammer away with the Vulcan.
Yep, just destroy them.
Yeah.
They got more valuable combat experience.
They did. There we go. Blew them up.
Nice.
Contact Civvies,
and yep, they're gone.
They're gone. Yeah, typical.
All right, let's repair.
Pussy!
Repair drone control, oxygen, and heal up Weixing.
Yeah. Fix these things, and then go back to your positions.
Weixing to the med bay. Weixing to the med bay, please.
Weixing. And you go there.
Everyone else to action stations.
Prepare to jump. Okay. So we've got store, quest.
I reckon you should make your way along to the quest, then back down to the store, to the nebula, then to the exit.
I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4.
No, I won't have enough time to do that.
No,
of course not.
I can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
No.
How many reckons I got here? 1, 2.
You've got about 4 or 5 locations, Geoff.
4. Yeah, I could probably do about 4. So.
It's good that the exit is so far to the right and at the bottom, and it's convenient.
I'm gonna take this one.
You could probably do 7 if you hit both the nebulas, because that does slow down the rebel fleet, which is moving along.
Okay. Oh, he's got
cloak
as well.
Did he just teleport over, or did he just mind control? He teleported over. Just one guy. That was a bad idea.
He's got a teleporter. He's got.
He doesn't have a clone bay or a med bay, so.
So what do I want to take out here? His weapons, because he's got a big old missile launcher.
Yep. That intruder's pretty much taken care of.
Still do not have any power on my O2, which
yep.
is silly.
Well, we're down to we're up to 77 on it.
It's okay. Helium. Weixing will go back in the bed bay when it's all finished.
And he missed.
And he did miss. But there's no med bay over there, so I'm just going to kill him. Take him out.
Do it. Send him over.
Let's do it. Keep an eye on those weapons. Make sure they go down when they do. Make sure when he fires that missile like that. Do that. He's going to miss me. Yeah.
Excellent timing.
Boom. And that's it. Woohoo. Loads of scrap.
Hell yeah.
And
they're repaired.
And 5 points repaired. Boom.
Totally worth it.
That's what we needed. No, ooh, oh, nearly did it.
So glad it gives you the warning.
Yeah.
See you later, boys. Because you can't revisit this space and hope to find that pirate marauding ship just floating there. Be gone.
It will. Yeah. Such a silly mistake to make. Schoolboy error if you do that. Well, I feel confident to go to the store now with 125 scrap and pretty good stats. So, what do we got?
No weapons. Nothing some new exciting. Crew members.
Could have more crew members, but I don't feel like that's particularly important right now. Have a couple more fuel.
Fix the ship. That. Ah, good as new.
Yeah, that's it. Let's go.
I remember what happened last time we did that.
That one's cool.
We've got to head up to the quest. No, we're not going to have time to get up there and back. It's going to be too risky.
Three. It is going to be risky. One, two, three.
It's going to be one hell of a risk.
It is. Sometimes in life.
Well, like I said, it's a gamble, but I wouldn't have taken it. I would have headed to the quest much earlier. I don't know why you started to come down this way for.
Well,
uneventful there. Now we get to the quest. Give them one fuel, four fuel, no fuel.
I'm going to give them four fuel.
And they gave you 54 scrap.
Which is a bargain.
That is a bargain.
I think I'm going to make it okay. That battle with the sun on there, though, is going to be a bore.
Let's aid the civvies. It's a pirate aggressor. He's got a teleporter, a clone bay, and he's got a rock man.
Mm-hmm.
Two rock men.
Yep.
A Zoltan, by the looks of it, and a human. It looks like they're heading to the... They're teleporters now.
Yep, so I'm gonna
let him teleport over. So looks like two coming over.
Over, yeah.
You come into the med bay.
Perfect.
Absolutely ideal. Because your crew will continue to regenerate whilst killing the enemy in the med bay.
They will indeed.
If you take out his teleporters, it'll stop him going back, but Vulcan's gonna take a little while to power up.
Yeah, it's gonna take too long.
Yep, they jumped away.
Yep. Fair enough.
They don't have a med bay, but they have a cloning bay. I don't know why they didn't just let them die. He let off a volley of shots then.
He did,
Vulcan cannon's now fully charged.
So this should start chipping down his shield in a minute.
Oh, just took a bit of hull damage, some damage to the O2.
That's cool. That's okay, his weapon's going to start getting done over now. He's not going to be
his weapons
to miss
are
now.
In the red.
I think.
His weapons are now on fire.
I think if I take out that med, that's it.
He's got no crew left.
He hasn't got a crew left.
Oh, no, he does. He has a guy
in the
teleporter,
there.
Which is going to...
He's going to go and fix that.
And if you can teleport over there...
I'm going to finish him off.
Yep. Ta-da.
And wait till he puts that
fire. The fire,
out.
Of course. Because your mantis will be taken. There you go.
Yep.
I know there's more fire.
It's okay. As soon as he's got that out. Rock Monster's amazing at taking out fire. But as soon as he's taken that out, that's it. Now you're dead.
Yep.
Ah! Gotcha.
Nice.
And
they repaired us.
Fixed me up as well.
Happy days.
Oh, happy days. Right, so I've got scrap now. Time to start putting some upgrades in.
Yep.
Now I want maximum cloaking. That's what
more
I want.
Power.
Accept, and yes, I will grab an extra power as well.
Okay. Now when I'm playing, I usually do... One of my first upgrades is to actually upgrade the pilot, because I always think that upgrading the pilot increases the evasion of dodging missiles, but...
It does indeed, yeah. I mean, it depends what kind of game style you're going for.
Exactly,
exactly. Because some of the ships almost require you to focus on that, on trying to dodge stuff and just keep getting away, getting your FTL up and just keep jumping. But yeah, some of them are... More like, well, I mean, the Mantis ones are very much like on get on board and just kill everybody type thing.
Yeah.
Oh dear.
Right, we are going to be in danger here from the sun.
Are in danger a lot from the sun here, and I'm going to just.
But the enemy has no shields, but does have mind control.
Take him out as quick as possible.
So our Mantis are fighting each other in the med bay.
That's fine.
Which is fine.
Oh no, it's not fine because the other guy will die.
Really? Well, they not heal whilst they're in there.
He will not heal whilst he's mind-controlled, unfortunately.
Oh, you're right.
So I'm gonna...
Leave him in there to damage the med bay.
Yeah, he can damage it a bit.
Oh, he's back to normal, he's healing now. Yep. You can trust the Mantis to fight each other. It's like trusting two Klingons to not fight each other.
Yeah, very much so. They are.
Oh, weapons control just took a hit. It's on fire.
Oh, that's from the
solar flares.
That's annoying, that is.
Do we not have shields against solar flares? Okay, we've now got fire in the O2 rooms and the main connecting corridor.
Yeah,
venting that into space.
Vent those, yeah.
There's a good chance that another section could get. Our engines are out.
That's okay. The weapons are back. I need the weapons back. Come on, yep. Vulcan. You can help fix that butters while Y-Shin goes and gets some health. Come
Enemy
on,
shots
fire. Go out.
O2 is now gone.
Shit. That's really bad because I just vented the O2. So I'm going to have to get this guy in here and do one of those little runny things.
Yeah, and we need to get some Engie in the O2 room.
Yeah, Engie's going in. He's going to try and fix it as quick as possible. Come
on. Do or die.
Come on, Vulcan. Take out their weapons.
O2 is repaired, and we've just got another fire in the engine room.
Bloody hell. This guy is pain in the neck. That's all his weapons down.
Engines are offline again. We've got another fire in engine room.
Right, we're not going to be taking fire from
scrap.
Him anymore. We just need to get our FTL back.
Which it's almost ready. As soon as the engine is repaired, and it is now. Ready to jump.
Okay. I'm getting out of here. As quick
as
possible.
It's possible ships, but at least this one's less threat than the other one.
Yeah. It's not good to jump into a fight with damaged systems.
Indeed. Well, looks like we've got pirate scout ship in front of us. Can't even tell what's on there right now.
Yeah, Butters needs to go back to... I think this is going to be all right, though. Oh, we found out what's on it.
Yep. Intruders, where are they? In the weapons
room? In the
room?
Weapons, yeah. So they're going to go into there. He's going to go in there to help him back out. Where's Butters?
I don't know.
There's Butters.
Yep.
Butters is going to go find out what's on the scan. No, he's not. He's going to fix the O2.
Yeah, just so it's fully ready. He's got a bunch of weapons, and I guess he's just firing his first volley at you now.
Mm-hmm.
Managed to take down shields and a few bit of hull damage.
Oh, hopefully I'll get to through his shields.
You need to
get
through his shield soon, yeah.
Take out his thing in a minute.
Cloak is ready.
Go there. Oh, that's a good point, yeah. Let's cloak that. That's my... Weapon continues to spool up. And right, so yeah, we've just got two NG over there. Once I've taken out those weapons.
Yeah, because
I'm
that.
Just gonna go
his weapons are a threat at the moment.
Yeah, they certainly are.
Okay, we've bypassed the shields and we've taken out his weapons. Almost.
Yeah, let's get it into red.
Yeah.
And then I'll teleport into there.
He's still firing off a few shots, not enough to get past our shields. We're not getting through his shields just yet either.
His pilot seems to be quite good. Oh,
yeah,
there we go,
a bit more.
He's resisting.
Ah, he just hit our. We just damage to our pilot and to our bridge.
Right, I'd say that is enough damage to them. So I'm gonna put that there.
Send him over.
Sure that's not firing anymore. He stood there repairing it faithfully whilst I smashed him. But
yep.
Didn't work out for him so well.
Nice.
There we go.
Lots of scrap.
So
lots of fuel.
Teleport them back.
Get them into the med bay.
Put them in the med bay. And put Fleischy in the med bay because he took a hit.
Yep.
Put them back in here.
Ready for the next away mission.
Yeah.
And get the pilot back. And of course, our Engie back on weapons.
Yep, and we're back out again. So
well,
we should be able to get out of this system. Yep, brilliant. Ooh.
Calling her about their specialty.
Speciality. Oxygen system for 37 scrap.
I'm going to say no this time.
It's expensive.
Indeed.
It only costs me. Oh,
50.
Oh, it would have cost me 50.
Yeah. But it's very rare you can upgrade oxygen tanks to the highest.
Yeah. What I do need is more power.
Yep.
Now I can put on my...
On your drones.
Yeah.
But it costs a drone to launch it each time, remember? So.
It does, yep. Okay, so second to last sector.
Wow. Good run-ins, Geoff. Good run-ins.
Pretty good, pretty good. I'm pretty sure this is... I think this is uneasy. We'd have to have a look again at our own video to see what setting we put it on. I'm pretty sure this is easy though, with the amount of scrap I've been getting.
Yeah.
And now, so now I can put on that combat drone when there's a ship, but there's nothing here.
Oh, distress court. We're in another Engi controlled sector.
Let's go to the... Yeah, let's go straight for the distress call. Search for the ship.
What was it?
Ship coated with ice or crystal.
A few asteroids get past your shields and partially damage your engines. You'll have to pull out. God damn it.
Great.
I thought, what, didn't we buy sensors to avoid that kind of crap?
Jeez. Yeah. Didn't happen for us.
And you just somehow managed to hit the engines.
I did loads of hull damage. That was so ridiculous, right? I don't really
definitely
want to
sit don't on want the to go
there. Sun again, yeah.
Nope.
I can go down that way once I've gone that way. So I'm gonna go one there.
Sounds good. Okay.
All right.
So Mantis aggressor. He's got Mantis, quite a crew. Yeah. Quite a crew, and he does have a cloning bay.
Does.
And a teleporter.
Mantises.
Yeah, I think he's about to teleport over.
He's definitely about to teleport over. He's got big old rocket launcher there, which I'm going to try to avoid. I'm going to put the combat drone on.
Nice. Yep, they've come over, and they're in our sensor room.
That's okay. So he can. Butters is going to have to do a runner. Probably.
Yeah. Fine for now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Here,
they'll take care of those.
Yeah.
But they will respawn again over on the enemy ship.
Yeah.
Wow, Scoops, even though he's a master at combat, is taking a beating. Oh! Oh, he died.
Did he just die?
He just died. We just suffered our first loss. It's because the room's on fire.
Yeah, that bomb just blew it up.
Yeah, and Nikki's also on fire. That bomb also blew up the enemy.
Shit.
We just lost our most combat efficient.
We did.
Mantis.
We just lost him.
That's Scoops.
Not good. No.
I'm gonna be scooping him out of the sensor room now.
And there's no going back.
We got either. Fires in the sensor room.
Come on, take out that clone bay. Take out.
Hull is down to just under 2/3.
That's it. He's not
coming
back.
Be resurrecting. Yeah.
Taking out his weapons. Come on. Yes, that's it. Right, he's in trouble now. Take out his shields.
The fire in the sensor room has been taken care of.
Sweet. Butters can fix it. Ah, oh, I'm a man down now as well.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, we've only got one Mantis to send on away missions.
Yep, that's really bad. I want a rock man.
Oh, there's a store. Yeah.
Let's hope I can buy some crew.
Yeah.
177 scrap though, it's not bad.
Oh, look at that. They're all NG.
Wow. Every single one in NG. Brilliant.
Well, God, there's a whole repair drone, but it's quite expensive.
The hull repair drone is actually pretty damn useful, if I'm honest.
Yep.
I'm gonna buy it.
Okay, swap it out for the combat drone.
Yeah. And getting a little low on fuel.
We are gonna need to save some money. We're gonna need some more weapons before the end.
Yeah,
we're close to the end now.
I mean, there's every risk we will not find a shop with any weapons in it, because it's all random generated.
Absolutely.
So let's, fingers crossed, hope we find one, but...
Well, you've made it this far, it'd be... But did you not learn from the last time? You dock with a fueling station, it's going to explode in your face.
Yeah, well...
Next time we come across a fueling station...
Ignore it.
We nuke it from you know, a good distance.
From a good circling distance.
Yes,
yeah.
It's the only way to be sure. Alright, they've taken out our oxygen.
Yeah, and they've also flipping ruined me, really.
They've just taken out drones as well.
But these are the kind of guys who'd be really easy to take out.
Just taking more hull damage. Yeah, they would have been.
Bjorn is going to come over here. He's going to come over here, and I'm going to have to...
Ow! We got fires in...
Did that rocket launch rip me?
Yeah.
I was trying to...
Butters is pretty weak, and drones are totally out.
Right, I'm going to sort these douchebags out now.
Get that Vulcan powered up.
Yeah, I'm just going to kill them.
Did you board them?
I boarded with the Mantis and
Bjorn.
Yeah, Bjorn's experienced in combat. pretty experienced, so...
You reckon? We've got a mantis who's dying somewhere. An Engi who's dying somewhere.
Oh, yeah.
There's no oxygen in that room.
Shit. That was close. We got him.
Look at that. I said it. We needed more weapons.
And we got a new beam. Now that beam...
Somebody sold all our other weapons. Damn, we just took another hit drone room.
Oh, ouch.
I'm going to be in trouble.
Well, at least I can heal them all up.
Yep, heal everybody up. Get everyone back into position. And just hope morale doesn't drop as low as our hull.
We got hammered, didn't we? We got absolutely hammered. I'm going to have to upgrade the weapon systems in order to be able to use these, which I don't have enough money to do. Oh, dear.
Yeah, the hull beam is another 3.
Yeah, it's not looking pretty. It's not looking pretty.
Really isn't.
We're probably going to get to the boss and then get murdered.
Yeah, it happens a lot. There's the store.
It's going to go here. Where's the store?
It was to your left, but you've moved further to the right, towards the exit.
Okay. Oh, another dastardly trap. What a surprise.
He's cloaked as well.
No. Wait.
Really?
Yep.
He teleported over. He's in the door control room.
Okie dokie. Oakley dokie.
Man, how can you be so cheerful when we're taking... when we've got boarding party members and... I just always feel uneasy. Well, it's a good time you cloaked them when that missile flew across. I just feel uneasy when I see the hull go down below the halfway mark.
Yeah. Well, I think that is fair because it is dangerous. But we're going to get him anyway. Right. Oh, this Vulcan charge. I didn't even shoot it. What am I going to shoot? That.
Take out his weapons. Yep.
Badly.
Okay, we've taken care of the intruders.
Yeah. Butters is going to swap with Bjorn.
He's cloaked again. And we've just lost drone control.
Not good. I'm not going to change it.
We've just lost the bridge. Here we are now.
We're in
trouble. We've just lost the
O2
room.
We're going to get fucked.
We just lost the engines.
Oh, no.
Geoff.
This is all going to fall apart.
Geoff.
Quick.
Cloak. Maybe the enemy won't see us explode. We've got a fire in the teleportation room.
Oh, and they've just teleported in. They're going to die, though.
Oh, my God.
I need to fix
it. Geoff, we've come so far.
Oh, my God. Look at this.
Oh, my God. We just lost our pilot.
Oh, my God. No!
Oh, we didn't even get a chance to get to the life pods.
There you go.
One last explosion marks your fate, your shit stain across the universe.
Yep. Didn't even get to see the boss. That is FTL, my friend. That is the punishment that is this game.
Absolutely.
You will probably, if you do play this game, you will probably rage quit it, uninstall it, and then like 2 days later, you're gonna go, I'm sure I can do it this time. But that's why you keep coming back to this game, because you think, if I just did that a little bit differently, or if I just got lucky, a little bit luck, and I could get past that bit. Fantastic. I really love this game.
I remember on the playthroughs where I have completed it, I find myself just wanting, when I replay it, to refine those weapons and those scenarios that helped me get there again.
Yeah.
But what I found with replaying is just learning and adapting to what the game throws your way.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, depending on what you can buy in the stores, or getting lucky when you go to fueling platforms and instead of blowing up and damaging your hull, they give you like 5 fuel and give you an option of taking a crew member or just something else.
It's
roguelike.
You
don't know what to expect. So even though you might get the same mission pop up and the same multiple choices, you might choose the same choice and get a totally different outcome.
Yep. You never know what you're gonna get. And that's why I like it. That's why I've thoroughly enjoyed it and it's kept me playing it.
Absolutely, which is why we've done an extra special video this Gaming Friday, of course. Mostly on Gaming Fridays, they're just going to be half an hour long, but this one's an exception because FTL is near and dear to me. It's an absolutely special game, and it's one that I just enjoy playing over and over again, just for the music, just for the switch off, you know? You just get immersed in the tactical flow of the game, and you just want to try and search everywhere.
Yeah.
I highly recommend you go and play FTL if you've never played it before.
Yeah, if you like any kind of management games, you're going to like FTL. You really are, because it's such charm to it and so much fun. Replayable to the max. Love it, love it!
Absolutely. Okay, so we're just going to close up now by saying thanks for watching, everyone. It's been an epic 2 hours.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Geoff.
And
of course, you can check us out on Facebook and keep up to date on Twitter. We have film reviews going up on Thursdays. And tomorrow, on Saturdays, we have me and Ian playing sequential playthroughs of video games. Tomorrow will be the last episode of the Thing playthrough.
Dum, dum, dum.
So stay tuned, everyone, and I'll see you then.
Take it easy.